name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to layer our previously created 4 different colored sugar water solutions. So the first thing that we're going to need for the experiment is going to be the sugar water solutions, for which by now we know the density. We have the blue, the green, the yellow, and the red. We also need an Erlenmeyer flask, and I like to use this one because it keeps this study and it's rather transparent, so I know exactly what is happening inside the test tube, which I also need because I will be layering the solutions in it. To do the layering successfully, we need to add the solutions very, very slowly, so this is where good pipetting skills will be essential. I'm going to use a clean and dry pipette. For this pipette, I also need a pipette bulb so I can control the amount of solution that is brought up. Based on my measurements from the previous step, I know that for me, the most dense solution is going to be the red one. So I will start with this. I will use my pipette, control the glass portion with 2 fingers and the bulb with other 2. This will allow me to separate the control of the pipette and the control of the bulb. Then I am going to squeeze the pipette bulb and place the tip of my pipette in the solution. And then as I slowly release my grip on the bulb, it will pull up the red solution. And because the red solution is rather viscous, this may take a minute. Once it is rather full, I will gently transfer the solution into the bottom of the test tube that is inside the Erlenmeyer and release it without touching the walls of the test tube. And when all the solution is released, I will slowly pull it up without touching the walls of the test tube. And I will repeat this process until I have enough of the red solution to create a layer that is at least 1 finger's width high. That should be a solid enough layer. I will set my red solution to the side, squeeze it out in my waste container, and then pull up some water so that I can rinse off my red solution. Ideally, one would do this 2 or 3 times to consider the pipette ready for the next use. Just like we did with the previous transfers, it has a couple little droplets of water. We're going to start pulling up some of the yellow solution, squeeze it back in, and we'll do this 1 or 2 before we are ready to begin the transfer and the layering. When we are ready, we pull up a significant amount of the yellow solution, and this is really important and critical. Very slowly and very carefully, we have to transfer this content in there, but this time it cannot be rushed. It has to be very, very slow to create this layer between the red and the yellow solutions. So I will lower myself to eye level with my solution, and then very gently, dropwise, I'm going to add the yellow layer until I see a clear separation between the red and the yellow layers. I will get very close to the yellow layer so that the drop that I'm adding is slowly creating another layer. And again, I'm trying not to touch at all the walls of the test tube. And slowly we should start to see the layer of yellow emerge. And I will add just a little bit more of the yellow solution to make my layer a little bit thicker. Just like before, we need to squeeze out all the yellow solution, pull up some clean water, and then transfer it into a waste container or the sink. Next, we rinse in the green solution into the pipette. And we're ready to do the layering with the green solution. Just like with the yellow one, we're going to get to eye level as much as possible, and then lower the solution just to the interface of the yellow, and then very slowly dropwise add the green solution until a very identifiable layer forms. When we are satisfied with the thickness of the green layer, we set that aside, squeeze out the remaining green solution into our waste bin, draw up some clean water, and rinse it out two or three times before moving on to our final layer, which will be the blue. We rinse it again a couple times. And when we feel that we have a good sense for the behavior of this solution, we draw up a sufficiently large amount and then carefully begin the layering of our final blue solution. And with that, we have our four layers inside the test tube, and they are all clearly identifiable. We have the red, orange on the bottom. Then we have the yellow, the green, and then the blue at the very top. If you would like to try, you can add some water on the very top. If the density difference between the water and the least dense sugar water solution is at least similar to the difference between the other layers. Next, you can do your own experiments from here. You could try shaking your test tube and seeing what happens. You could try cleaning your test tube, rinsing it with water and drying it completely, and then trying to layer your solution in a different order to see if they would layer similarly.